You know, sometimes you just need to get rid of what you have in your Notion workspace, but you don't want to delete it. So how can you take something and archive it, similar to what the para method asks for in Notion? Let's talk about that. So jumping into the TTP/evergreen-notion-workspace, I have a pretty interesting layout on my homepage. As you'll notice, there is a bunch of toggle H2s set up here with the different trees of my life. So why do I have it like this? The reason is all of these toggle H2s are actually filtered so that you can see the different trees that exist. When it comes to those trees and branches, we have roots and resources. So roots are project databases that are recurring. You know, you're always gonna have goals, you're always gonna have YouTube videos if that's something that you're keeping up, whereas a one-off project is different. And you're always gonna have resources as there's something to reference. But if we look at this, we'll see in the filtering on the resources, this archive is unchecked. So what does that mean? Essentially in Notion, the nice thing about having properties is that you can add a property that would actually archive things from the different views that you have. So in my opinion, there is no situation in which you should utilize Notion from its original database. You should only ever use the linked database to interact with. And the reason for that is, say I wasn't going to use this anymore. All I would need to do was archive this, and it would disappear from the functioning side of what I'm doing, rather than me deleting it and then losing it forever. However, it doesn't bug me in the sense that I don't need to deal with looking at it when I'm trying to work through things. But if I wanted to go back into the database itself and made a view for the archive section, I can actually see that there is an archived item here, so I can uncheck this. So let's give you a practical example on how to make this happen. So say you wanted to make a resources database. What I would recommend you do is make one of these guys, put a little file storage looking situation here, maybe make it the page full width. And then what I would recommend you do is make a /database, and it'd be an inline or a full page here. So I would do an inline database, and I would call this resources. Now the difference between this database and what would happen if I were to duplicate this is, if I did this and duplicated it, this is actually just making another database, because if you'll see, I type, it doesn't affect it. But if I took this guy, copy the link and pasted it somewhere, create linked view of database. That's what I'm doing. I'm copying an existing view from there. This is working on the same database. So I'm gonna delete this, and I'm actually gonna take this resources database, and I'm immediately gonna turn it into a page. Because what I don't want is, I don't want this being utilized as the main source of edits, because it's just better to have your linked databases be separate from your real ones, just in case you accidentally delete them. It's better to have these in a different place. I actually have an entire situation where on the TTP hub, in this The Earth page, is where I actually have the real databases. So I'm never interacting with this page. I'm never accidentally gonna delete anything. But if we go back here and make an example resources page, all you really need to do is, say for example, you make a second brand page, or you make a meal planner, and you're really at this point where you don't wanna use a meal planner anymore. How do you get to the point where you have it archived? You make a new property, and you can do a couple different things. You can do a checkbox, which is easy. You can do a select property where you have one that says archived or current, but I'm gonna just do a checkbox here, and then we'll see this situation going on. So what I would actually recommend is, if you're gonna do some sort of resource, you can have a nice little gallery view here. And then if you wanted to change the gallery, you have the choice to have it have any sort of preview or anything, or change the size, make it a large card, medium card, small card, whatever your heart's desire is. But then what you could do is, you could filter it so that the checkbox is unchecked. So then if I'm ever interacting with this and it's like, oh, I don't really want to deal with this in my resources anymore, I want to archive it. And you know, if I really wanted to go back into it, I could save it for later. I can archive this meal planner. And then what I'm interacting with wouldn't have this in my resources, because it's not a thing you want to use anymore, but you're not going to delete it, because you never know, you may need to use it in the future, and it doesn't hurt because you have unlimited blocks in Notion. So then if I go back into resources though, it would still have it here, and you could even make another view. So you duplicated this, you would call it archived resources, and call the original one current resources. Then if we go back to the archived one, all you'd have to do is change the filter so that the checkbox is checked, and then save for everyone. And then from here, you have two different views showing your resources that are archived and aren't. And then another thing that you could do is check out this video on how to improve your Notion to get tips like this.